Retired Admiral Nora Satie, whose investigation exposed the alien conspiracy against Starfleet Command 3 years ago, is arriving to assist in our inquiry.
How did you damage the dilithium chamber?
I had nothing to do with that.
You mean it was sheer coincidence that it was sabotaged after you gave the plans for the design to the Romulans?
I do not know. I had nothing to do with it.
You've admitted your crime. Why lie now?
I am not lying.
Tell me, what is your relationship with the Klingon, Jadam?
There's no relationship. He just came in for his injections.
Did you give him those injections?
Sometimes. He's lying. He's desperately frightened. He's covering something.
You must not expect me to permit any action against Mr. Tarsis solely on the basis of Betazoid intuition.
Do you have a Betazoid counselor? Surely you're aware of the advantages.
There is a difference between a counselor and an investigator.
Sabin and Lieutenant Worf are continuing to investigate. But if you don't act until then, it may be too late.
To our investigation must be that the explosion was not intentional.
That's the way I see it. This wasn't sabotage at all. It was nothing more than an accident.
I'm opening the hearing to spectators.
It isn't good to have closed-door proceedings for too long. It invites rumor and speculation.
Nevertheless, Admiral, I think it would be wise.
Because spies and saboteurs don't like the bright lights of an open inquiry. They're like roaches scurrying for the dark corner.
What?
Isn't it true that the paternal grandfather of whom you speak was not a Vulcan, but was in fact a Romulan? That it is Romulan blood you carry, and a Romulan heritage that you honor? We're waiting, Mr. Tarsis.
On the advice of my counsel, I refuse to answer that question in that the answer might serve to incriminate me.
You see what is happening here, Mr. Worf.
Sir.
This is not unlike a drumhead trial. 500 years ago, military officers would upend a drum on the battlefield. They'd sit at it and dispense summary justice. Decisions were quick, punishments severe, appeals denied. Those who came to a drumhead were doomed.
The Federation does have enemies. We must seek them out.
Oh, yes. That's how it starts. But the road from legitimate suspicion to rampant paranoia is very much shorter than we think.
I wanted to be out there, traveling the stars. I didn't want to wait for anything. But now it's done, isn't it? My career in Starfleet is finished.
Not if you aren't guilty, Simon.
Doesn't matter. I lied on my application. And that mistake will be with me for the rest of my life.
The hearings are not going to stop. They're going to be expanded.
What do you say?
I'm going to get to the heart of this conspiracy, if it means investigating every last person on this ship. And every hearing from now on will be held in the presence of Admiral Thomas Henry of Starfleet Security. I've requested he be brought here at once.
You never told me about this.
I report to Starfleet Command directly. I do not need your permission or your approval of my decision.
Admiral, what you're doing here is unethical. It's immoral. I'll fight it. I'm deeply concerned about what is happening here. It began when we apprehended a spy, a man who admitted his guilt and who will answer for his crime. But the hunt didn't end there. Another man, Mr. Simon Tarsis, was brought to trial, and it was a trial, no matter what others choose to call it. trial based on insinuation and innuendo. Nothing substantive offered against Mr. Tarsis, much less proven. Mr. Tarsis' grandfather is Romulan. And for that reason, his career now stands in ruins. Have we become so fearful? Have we become so cowardly that we must extinguish a man because he carries the blood of a current enemy? Admiral, let us not condemn Simon Tarsis or anyone else because of their bloodlines, or investigate others for their innocent associations. You know, there are some words I've known since I was a schoolboy. With the first link, the chain is forged. First speech censured, the first thought forbidden, the first freedom denied, chains us all irrevocably. Those words were uttered by Judge Aaron Satie as wisdom and warning. First time any man's freedom is trodden on, we're all damaged. I fear that...
How dare you! You who consort with Romulans, invoke my father's name to support your traitorous arguments. It is an offense to everything I hold dear. And to hear those words used to subvert the United Federation of Planets. My father was a great man. His name stands for integrity and principle. You dirty his name when you speak it. He loved the Federation. But you, Captain, corrupt it. You undermine our very way of life. I will expose you for what you are. I've brought down bigger men than you, Picard.
It is over. Admiral Henry has called an end to any more hearings on this matter.
That's good. Villains who twirl their mustaches are easy to spot. Those who clothe themselves in good deeds are well camouflaged.
I think, after yesterday, people will not be so ready to trust her.
Maybe. But she or someone like her will always be with us, waiting for the right climate in which to flourish, spreading fear in the name of righteousness. Vigilance, Mr. Wolf. That is the price we have to continually pay.